You know, I remember my grandmother making these very same cookies. I remember tasting this bad.
But Les, it's Christmas. You gotta have ham. That's what pigs are for.
What do you think Carlson's gonna do?
He's gonna do the fair thing.
Well, brownie?
Thanks. Who made these?
I did.
Maybe later.
My little contribution to the Christmas party. Speaking of contributions, what do you hear from Carlson?
Not a word.
Well, here's the man to ask. How about it, Travis? Is Carlson going to stiff us again this year?
I don't know.
He gave us each $25 last year.
I know.
People in prison get bigger bonuses than that.
I know.
They do.
Who made these?
Johnny.
Listen, Travis, I got a tiny little gray-haired grandmother at home who's still watching a black-and-white TV set. Now, before she dies, I want her to see Eight is Enough in color. I mean, that's a dream of mine, and that's why I need that bonus money.
Well, what about me? Let's get to me now.
I mean, my poor little daughter has sucked her thumb since infancy. She needs braces, Travis. Her teeth are all over the place. I mean, she's got one over here, and then she got one back here. I just want to fix those teeth. That's what my bonus is for.
Very commendable.
I'm just trying to be the best darn father I can be.
Well, come on, Bailey. How about you?
Well, I think grannies and daughters are very touching. But frankly, I'm in it for the bread, you know what I mean?
The very simple truth is...
Hi, Les.
Hi, Andy. That for the last half decade, Mr. Carlson has promised us that when this station reached fiscal soundness, we, the employees, would share in that financial good fortune. Well, my fine feathered friend, that time is now upon us. The chickens have come home to roost. Push has come to shove. The hogs have all gone to market. The cows are out to pasture.
Look, everybody.
I'm on your side in this, but it's Carlson's decision. Now, while he's a very fine, upstanding man with many enduring qualities, I do not think we can forget that he has Genghis Khan for a mother.
Who has Genghis Khan for a mother?
I do.
Must be epidemic.
Yes, sir, it is.
Why aren't you on the air, Fever?
I'm a morning man, and it's 5 p.m.
Well, just because it's Christmas doesn't mean we drop the ball. This is a business here.
Last year you said it was a family.
Yes, well, you know, it's a family business. Hard-nosed decisions have to be made year-round. I'm not here to win a popularity contest. Can't do that and run a radio station at the same time, you know. Can I have one of these?
Yeah, eat them all.
Frank, we just need to bear in mind that we're going to make this year's Christmas party the best Christmas party that WKRB has ever had. Being ever mindful that these are hard and frugal times.
Any more questions about bonuses?
Well, it seemed to me that he was trying to set us up for some bad news.
That's that reporter's instinct of yours, Les.
Without braces, who's going to marry my daughter?
I will, Herb.
Hello. Oh, hi, Jennifer. No, I can't speak to anybody right now. I'll have him call me next year. February's good for me. Thank you.
Okay.
Now I know that you all feel like you should be getting a more substantial bonus this holiday season. The fact of the matter is, we just simply can't afford it. We've made improvements, but we still must continue to reinvest. To reinvest the profits. Slight profits. You know, I'm reminded of a very interesting story that Barry Buckman once told at a Kiwanis meeting. It seems that Barry's bank, his bank, which, by the way, was a member of the FDIC, his bank,
ever became of me. I'm living on the air in sense.
WKRP. Got kind of tired of packing and unpacking from town to town, up and down the dial. Maybe you and me were never meant to be. Just maybe think of me once in a while. I'm at WKRP in Cincinnati.
I'm sorry, he's very busy. Could you call us back in February?
This is your grandfather, Arthur Boy, back from the cold, dark grave.
But you're dead.
I just said back from the cold, dark grave. Try to pay attention, okay?
I'm sorry.
I've come here...
Wait a minute. This isn't going to be another one of those Charles Dickens Christmas Carol things, is it?
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy.
What?
I said, oh, boy.
Oh, I've come here to tell you that you're going to have to change your ways before it's too late.
What do you mean, too late? And what's wrong with my ways?
I'm warning you, Arthur. Because I made profit my life's work, I've been condemned to walk the face of this earth and witness the happiness that might have been. You see these chains? These are heavy suckers. But they're not nearly as heavy as it's going to be for you lugging that control board around.
How'd you know about that?
Well, that's what you're going to do with that bonus money, isn't it? Buy a control board for the DJ booth?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's not just going to benefit me. That's for the benefit of everybody.
Oh, who's kidding who? You're buying that control board to show your mother what a successful man you are.
That's not true.
Arthur, I'm a ghost, I know.
It's sure nice to see you again, Grandfather. But there are no ghosts. I'm dreaming, and I'm going to wake up now. Bye. So long, and happy holidays.
Buster, before you wake up, you're going to be haunted by three ghosts.
Yeah, got it. One, two, three. Three ghosts.
Heed their words. Might be good for you. I got to run. Any questions?
Yeah, I can't wake up.
I know.
Well, Scrooge could wake up.
He didn't eat one of Johnny's brownies.
Jennifer! Jennifer, I... Never mind.
Are we ready to go?
Go where?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Oh, come on, Jennifer, knock that.
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Okay, don't have to get huffy about it.
Now we must go back. Back into the past. Into a Christmas of the past.
Oh, gee, I don't know. I
come with me.
Wake up, Art. What year is this?
It's December 24th, 1954.
That's me. I used to have Herb Darlick's job. I was sales director.
I know.
And there's old Don Bassett. Meanest news man that ever lived. Only I thought he died years ago.
He did.
Oh.
Come on, boys. It's time to exchange our presents. Mr. Armour is on his way.
It's Mrs. Butterworth, the receptionist. Wow, this brings back memories. Hello. Arthur Carlson here, sales manager. Oh, hi, Mr. Finney. Really? Hey, that's great. No, I'll be over right after the holidays. Yeah, thanks a lot. And Merry Christmas. Hey, everybody, I've got the Finney Volkswagen account.
Oh, Arthur, give me a big hug. Oh, that's wonderful.
I was quite a salesman in my day.
Nobody's going to buy those cars. They're too small and they're too ugly. It's a fad, just like TV.
Don't you listen, dear. Your mother's going to be so proud.
Always trying to please Mom.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Armour. Oh, say, Mr. Armour, I got the Finney Volkswagen account.
Oh, well, that's great, Arthur. Your mother will be very proud. But we mustn't talk about sales now. It's Christmas. And why won't those announcers play Christmas music? Why does it always have to be this stuff? Rock and roll.
Mr. Armour was a great guy. Worked in radio all of his life.
Now, Mrs. Butterworth, I believe I've already given you your present.
A black nightgown.
And, This is yours. And if it looks like a box of cigars, you're right.
Cigars?
You're right.
Arthur,
this is for you.
Gee, so big.
Open it up, Artie.
Okay, I will. You really wrap this up. What is it?
It's a flamingo.
Yes, it's for your yard. It's the newest thing. They're all the rage down in Florida.
Oh, gee, thanks.
My pleasure, son.
Get a load of this.
Shaboom, shaboom. Hey, Mr. Bassett.
We ought to get this on the air right away.
More McCarthy stuff.
Oh, no, this is really important. President Ike played golf in Philadelphia. He shot an 84.
Well, get right on it, Les. Front page news.
Merry Christmas.
What is it?
Well, it's a tie, Les, but a very important tie. You're no longer just an office boy. Don and I have decided to make you a real full-blown cub reporter.
Full-blown? Oh, Mr. Armour, I promise you'll never see me without a tie again. Thank you.
And now, folks, it's time for the Christmas bonuses. I'm sure Arthur's mother is not going to like this very much, but darn it, I run this radio station, and you people have got it coming. We're a great team if there ever was one. There's yours, Arthur.
Oh, thank you.
And, Don?
Thanks, Homer.
And there you go. Merry Christmas, Mrs. Butter.
You know what happened next, don't you, Mr. Carlson?
He shouldn't have done it. He did it without Mother's approval.
So she fired him.
I don't know what other choice she had.
Come on and have a drink, boys. Come on. Here we go.
Mr. Armour was the one.
There you are, my dear.
I'm going to have fun spending the night.
Oh, there's a special Arthur.
Yeah.
Thank you. Les, you're going to have a little bit?
Just a little.
Just a little bit. And drive carefully going.
Time to go.
Oh, please, no. Just one cup of eggnog.
This is the specialty of the house. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Yeah, yeah, Merry Christmas.
It's time to go.
Oh, no. Come on, I haven't seen Don Bassett since, well, since he died.
I'm sorry, Mr. Carlson. It's time to go.
Oh. Goodbye, everybody. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Oh, how'd you do that?
Mostly luck. Have you learned anything from the past?
Look, if this was a successful station, there'd be no question about bonuses. Of course I'd give. Don't fade on me. Look, we're just beginning to see the light at the end of the tunnel. I mean, we're just now getting our heads above water, just starting to operate in the black. What else can I do? Don't go. Uh-oh. Gone. I'm alone. And in bad lighting again.
Hey, see, come on in, man. Come closer, my boy.
You must be the ghost of Christmas present.
Say what?
I said you must be the ghost of Christmas present.
That's right.
Can you turn down this music?
Sure.
Damn, that's fun.
Boy, that's... Can I do that?
I'm sorry, see, you gotta be a ghost. You're just some guy having a dream.
Can you turn up these lights?
Sure. What can I do for you, AC?
Well, aren't you gonna take me somewhere?
Don't have to. We can do it right here. Hold that.
Give me that.
Excuse me.
Somehow I feel you're new at this stuff.
Worship the man.
I must be awake. There's her.
Kowtow to him. I am his number one yes man lackey. And what do I get for it? Nothing. Zippo. Uno zero.
I just get ahead these days.
How, AC?
I knocked myself out and worked twice as 3 times as hard as any man, and this is the thanks I get.
These are your employees, Mr. Carlson. We're a great team if there ever was one.
Oh, Lucille, guess what, babe? We're not getting bonuses again this year. I don't know why.
We're a family business, huh? Where hard-nosed decisions have to be made, right, AC?
I don't know, honey. I guess when she grows up, we'll just have to put her in a convent.
He's gonna get his daughter braces with his bonus money.
Bailey?
Mm?
One of us is gonna have to work Christmas Day.
Well, I'll do it.
No, I'll do it.
No. We'll flip a coin.
Okay.
It'll be tails.
Heads.
Call it, Les.
It's tails.
Tails.
It's heads.
She's lying.
Okay, I'll work.
But you won't.
No, I want to work.
That's the spirit.
Besides, I can't fly home. I can't afford it now.
Use a credit card. I do.
I don't want to ask my parents, you know.
Okay. Baby, did you try to steal my quarter?
Yes, I did. Andy, I just tried to steal a quarter from Les.
Why? Why can't you talk to Carlson about the bonuses?
Well, Les, I just did. Well,
what did he say?
And he's taking a nap.
I don't see how he can sleep.
It's the brownies.
Andy, I gotta tell you something. I've had 3 job offers this year, 1 for money. I just have got to start thinking about myself.
Me too. I mean, radio is my life. But I swear, wholesale appliances is where the money is. My neighbor, Big Dick Mushroom, he wants me to go in with him. And I'll tell you something else. I just might take him up on it.
You know, Andy, if people could just feel somehow as if they were sharing the station's progress.
I know, Les.
Some things are more important than money.
Oh, I know that.
More important than money?
Oh, look, everybody.
You tell him, Andy.
Carlson is,
Carlson is, what? Go on.
Well, he's...
Go on!
Cheap.
Right.
Oh, what? He's a scandal. He's a type one. What else can I tell you?
I don't want to see any more of this. Can I go back to my office? I think
you deserve it. Whatever you say, AC.
That's it for me. I don't want to see any more. To heck with the control board. Where's my checkbook? Yeah, you're too late, Fever. I'm writing out personal checks, gonna reimburse myself later.
My name is not Fever.
Oh, yeah, no, that's right. You'd be the ghost of the Christmas future.
At your service.
Judging from your outfit, my future's not too bright.
You're right.
Don't see it.
You must see it.
No, look, I'm doing away with the control board. Hey, yeah, that's writing the checks. You just go on home. Go away.
This trip is not to get you to write the checks.
It's not.
No, this trip is for you to understand the true spirit of giving. It's to teach you goodwill among men, peace on earth, God rest ye merry gentlemen. Joy to the world.
Great.
Adeste fidelis. Well, this trip is also to decide how big the checks will be.
You ghosts never give up, do you?
We're just here to help, Art.
Look, if it hadn't been for one of Johnny Fever's brownies, I wouldn't even be in this dream right now anyway.
Oh, lighten up, AC. There's nothing wrong with those brownies. Just because it was Johnny, everyone always jumps to the wrong conclusions. Poor Johnny. Always trying to do the right thing. Always misunderstood. Johnny was the kind of guy that always...
Look, can we just go?
Always. Sure.
What's this? It's all white. I thought my future was black.
This is the bullpen.
Oh, gee, well, we must have made some changes.
Oh, yes.
Good morning. This is the Xeroid Corporation of Cincinnati, Ohio.
Hello, Herb Tarlick here, General Sales Manager of WKRP in Cincinnati.
Hello, Herb.
I'm calling to ask if your company would like to advertise on our station.
No, thank you, Herb.
Perhaps I could call back next week.
Yes, Herb. Please do that. This has been a computerized transmission.
Okay, fine.
How far in the future are we?
Not as far as you would think.
Where is everybody?
The entire station has been automated. Herb is the only employee. There's no one else here. Kind of a warm feeling, isn't it?
What about Bailey, Melesh, and Travis?
Well, one by one, you sort of force them to quit. Bailey runs a television station in Chicago now. Travis is breeding guard dogs in New Mexico. Venus owns a clothing company called Upwardly Mobile. Jennifer married and bought herself an entire island off the coast of Sardinia. And Les Nessman, the Republican whip of the United States Senate.
What about you and me? Fever and me.
Well, Fever just sort of disappeared. There were rumors, of course, but really not much else.
No, don't tell me. I don't want to know. I'm dead, aren't I? Don't tell me. I don't want to know.
Oh. Oh, that's it for me. I'm bushed. Guess I'll go on home and trim the old aluminum tree.
Herb sort of taken to talking to himself now.
It's gonna be a nice Christmas. Little Herbie home from the forestry service. Bunny home from the convent. We'll all be together again. Oh. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, Herb.
That sure isn't like the old days.
Herb! Fever. The ghost. Whatever. It doesn't have to end this way, does it? I don't have to die friendless.
They say that people change their destinies just by missing a bus.
Oh, then things can change. Things can be different.
Maybe.
Oh, then take me back. Please, I'm dreaming tonight.
You must change your ways, AC, or else it will all end like this. Not a pretty picture.
Come on, Fever. Give me a break. I don't want to.
I want to live forever. Is that too much to ask?
Mr. Carlson?
Jennifer, it is you. It's over. The dream is over.
Yes, Mr. Carlson, whatever it was, it's all over now.
Oh, good. Where's my checkbook?
Left drawer.
That's wonderful. Just great. Where's my checkbook?
Left drawer.
Oh, yeah, my checkbook. Hey, when's the Christmas party?
About 20 minutes.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, I got plenty of time. You know, Jennifer, I saw ghosts. Yeah, real ghosts.
Mr. Carlson, that was just a dream. There were no ghosts.
They were wonderful.
Merry Christmas, AC.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Johnny. Merry Christmas. I saw ghosts. Yeah, real ghosts. Yeah, they showed me the light. You know, success at the expense of your friend is not success at all. It's better to give than to receive. And that stuff's true. So I'm going to get big bonuses this year. Big bonuses.
I guess talking to dead people will do that to you.
Yeah, they certainly will. Oh, golly, we're a team if there ever was one. You know, Mother probably won't like this, but darn it, I'm running the station. And you people have got it coming. Oh, listen, Fever, those brownies, I want them. Take those things over to Mother's house and I'll put one in her martini. I'll see you at the Christmas party. Merry Christmas. Jingle bell.
Merry Christmas.
God bless us, everyone.
Hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling, too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding...